Today I have a client who has beautiful natural hair. Look at this hair, gorgeous. So we're going to be coloring her today, just jet black, and then we're going to be adding some clip-ins for length and fullness. I know it looks super full right now, but my client's hair is actually really fine and a little bit on the thin side, but we're going to change that. The hair that we're going to be turning into clip-ins is going to be Rajio's Luxury Hair Extensions Natural Straight 18 inches. The hair comes in natural brown, so we're going to have to color it black to match my client's hair. Now I'm letting you all in on a little secret. So before adding clip-ins to my client's hair, we're going to straighten it first. But if you notice, I'm not putting the flat iron all the way to her roots. I want to leave some type of texture close to her root where the clip-in is going to be installed. If I make her hair too silky at the root, then we leave room for slippage. And we don't want her clip-ins slipping out. Here you can see the difference between her root and her hair shaft. Her root is not as silky as the rest of her hair. That will aid in holding that clip-in in place. So the materials we're going to need to make said clip-ins, you're going to need hair, of course. So this is the hair after we've already colored it. We're going to need thread and a needle. A pair of scissors, and the star of the show, you're gonna need clip-ins. I prefer the small ones, but they do come in different sizes. Notice how they open and close. And this is what the packaging looks like. And make sure the needle that you're using is small enough to fit through the hole in your clip. Okay, my client's hair is all flat iron. Now I'm gonna part her, and I'm going to measure the length that I want the clip-ins to be, so they'll be tailored to fit her head specifically. And when I say length, I'm talking about the length of the wefts, not the actual hair. Simply pinch the weft when you're satisfied with your track placement, and where your thumb is, that's where you're going to cut. We're going to be doubling our wefts, so we're going to have to cut two pieces. Another secret, y'all. The second weft that you're cutting, do not cut it the same length. I'm talking about the weft. Do not cut it the same length that you just cut your first weft. Hold it up against the weft you just cut to measure, and you're gonna cut it just a little bit short. Now here comes another secret, y'all. Once you've cut your tracks, what you're going to do, you're gonna take your scissors and you're going to split the track. Don't cringe, y'all. You won't have any shedding. You're going to split the track on both ends. You're going to do this to both wefts, but you're only going to do a very, very small amount. I'll show you. Just like this. And what you're going to do next, you're going to cut one side of the weft off. This is going to allow the edges of your extensions to lay more seamlessly. And this is what the wefts look like together. Center your shorter weft on the longer one. Now we're ready to sew our wefts together. You need to start out by going through your wefts. You're not taking the thread all the way to the end because that's just one track there. So we're gonna go through the weft a couple of times right there where the two wefts connect. Make sure you're doing a lock stitch. And once you have that first stitch secured, we're gonna go around our wefts until we work our way to the other end. There's your lock stitch. And when we get to the other end of the weft, to where the two tracks connect on the ends, make sure you end it with another lock stitch. I'm going around the wefts. This is gonna keep shedding to a minimal, if any at all. Once you've doubled your wefts, now it's time to add the clip-ins. And be sure that you're sewing your clip-ins on your weft right side up and not wrong side down. I'll show you that too. Be sure to line your clip-in up to the edge of your wefts. Otherwise, it's going to be like a little piece there that's going to stick out. We're going to go through these holes to install this on your clip-in. And then we're going to go through the teeth of the comb and around the wefts. You do need to penetrate your weft for the first stitch and the last stitch. The rest of the stitches in the middle, go around the weft. Again, this will keep shedding to a minimum, if any at all. Here I'm finishing it off, going through the hole and around the weft, and then I'm going to go back through the hole, and I went through the weft as well. And then you want to make sure that you're ending it with a lock stitch, and I'm going to go through it twice for a double knot. Okay, I've completed all of my clip-ins. I've made a total of 7. And take note, you could see that the longer clip-ins, the longer wefts have more than just 2 clip-ins. So you want to make sure you do that because you don't want your tracks to lift up when they're in your client's hair. You don't want the middle of it to bubble up. So you want to place the amount of clip-ins that'll allow your wefts to lay flat up against your client's hair. So, and the way you want to kind of measure where your clip-ins go. When the wefts are long, I'm going to show you. Always want to start out with putting clip-ins on both edges of your wefts. Then what you're going to do next is fold it in half, and you want to find your center. okay? And when you open it up, that center is where you're gonna place your next clip in. Then you're gonna fold it from the center clip and the end clip, and then you find your other two centers. Okay, so now it's time to go ahead and install these clip-ins in my client's hair. And I'm about to let y'all in on another secret. The secret is teasing or backcombing. If you just kind of rough up that area that you did not flat iron, it will help your clip-ins to grip it even better, especially if you have clients that have finer hair.